All right. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the 2020 Senior Scholarship Awards. My name is Tom Behrman. I'm the principal here at Alpena High School. I'm very excited to welcome you to a totally new format for this year's Senior Awards. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we've had to move most of our awards assemblies to a virtual type of platform, and this is no exception. So tonight, even though the format is different, it certainly does not tarnish in any way the accomplishments of the class of 2020. This evening, we are going to honor all of the academic accomplishments that each of these young men and women have accomplished during their 4 years here at Alpena High School. First, to get things started, we are going to have a special treat for everybody. We have two of our military-bound seniors, one, Toby Kruger, who's going to be attending or going into the U.S. Army, and we have Gabe Bullis, who is going to be attending the United States Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. So the first celebration we have tonight is going to be a pretty cool Pledge of Allegiance done remotely by both Toby and Gabe.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
All right, excellent job. Thank you to Toby and Gabe for that rendering of the Pledge of Allegiance. So we're going to be going through each of our awards. We have about 20 awards, 19 awards we're going to be going through. And then each one of them has a video. And then at the very end, we have Alpena High School English teacher, Mrs. Paula Gerke, who is going to be reading more of the individual accomplishments that we have. One disclaimer I do want to throw out there as we go through the proceedings tonight is we possibly could have missed a scholarship due to the scattered nature we've had to do this electronically. Normally, the seniors are in the building and they can bring us letters when they've been awarded these scholarships, and we're doing things a little bit scattered this year. So if we did by chance miss any student or any scholarship, please make sure that you get that to your counselor, and we'll make sure that we recognize you any way possible we can. We don't want to make sure we leave anybody out. So next we're going to move into a short video celebrating the 27 members of the graduating class that have been recognized with the BESSER Excellence in Education Scholarship, and we have a short video for that.
Remember on the first day, walking through the hallway, talking about how we couldn't wait. We could leave this place and graduate. Well, now we're in our last year, yeah, we should be there, surrounded by our friends, making memories. It's how it should be. Yeah, I wish that we could turn back time. But we will have to leave it all behind. So here's to the ones who won't get the chance to take the field at the last home game. For us that world around, we sing their school fight song. And here's to the ones who have to say goodbye to the past 4 years of their lives. They've been who they are. Well, here's to you. Here's to you. I'm standing in these four walls, thinking about the phone call when they told us we were done. Who would have thought that it would come to this? I'm trying not to look back, knowing that we'll get that diploma in our hands. Wanna be the same, but it won't be the same, and we know that we can never turn back time. So no, we won't have to leave it all behind. So here's to the one who won't get the the chance to take the wheel. Not the last home game. As I grow around, I sing this moonlight song. And here's to the one you have to say goodbye to. The past 4 years of their life. They've been who they are. Oh, here they are. To the rest of you alive, it's gonna fly right by. So be thankful for each moment and don't waste your time. And on the road ahead, I hope you understand that there was purpose in the hard times. So here's to the ones who won't get the chance to take the field at their last home game. As the girl to cry, sing their school fight song. And here's to the one who has to say goodbye to the past 4 years.
Excellent. Congratulations to all of the top 10% for Alpena High School. Each one of those 27 individuals will be awarded a $1,000 scholarship from the Besser Foundation. So again, congratulations to all of those students. Next, we have Alpena Community College recognizing the 2021 scholarship. We have a short video for them.
My name is Brenda Herman. I am the Executive Director of the Alpena Community College Foundation. I am honored today to present 45 scholarships to 22 outstanding Alpena High students. These scholarship funds have been created by generous donations made through the ACC Foundation by individuals, businesses, organizations, foundations, and service clubs. On behalf of the college and the ACC Foundation Board of Trustees, I proudly congratulate the recipients of our 2020-2021 ACC scholarships. Caitlin Allen, Joseph Pinson Scholarship, $500. Taylor Baker, Doreen McClay Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Ivan Brown, Helen and Bob Bonchek Scholarship, $500. Alexandria Bruni, Tom and Mary L. Lappin Scholarship, $500. Alger and Nancy Zapp Scholarship, $500. Hannah Berger, Jenny J. Greslack Memorial Scholarship, $3,000. Kiwanis Club of Alpena Scholarship, $500. Jean Martindale Memorial Scholarship, $250. Nikita Cortez, Robert R. Chater Memorial Scholarship, $500. Dutcher Family Scholarship, $1,000. Olivia Heron, Alex and Esther Kennedy Memorial Scholarship, $500. Lauren Johnston, Alpena Rotary Club Scholarship, $500. Elizabeth Kilishewski, Samantha L. Schrader Memorial Scholarship, $500. Connie Sue Bach Weinkoff Scholarship, $1,000. Dana LaBelle, Alex and Esther Kennedy Memorial Scholarship, $500. Patricia Piper Florence Isaacs Scholarship, $500. Samantha L. Schrader Memorial Scholarship, $500. Brooke Mayle, Alpena Rotary Club Scholarship, $500. Leo and Berthina Fleming Scholarship, $500. Dr. Catherine A. Hoppe Scholarship, $400. Kiwanis Club of Alpena Scholarship, $500. Samantha L. Schrader Memorial Scholarship, $500. Kimberly McConnell, Alpena Rotary Club Scholarship, $500. Shirlene M. Edgley and James J. Edgley Memorial Scholarship, $600. Dr. and Mrs. Frederick Odell Scholarship, $500. Bruce and Patsy Omart Scholarship, $500. Brady Oliver, Leo and Berthina Fleming Scholarship, $500. Philip Noble Memorial Scholarship, $500. Nehemiah Rao, Marie Sexsmith Griffin Scholarship, $1,000. Jewel and Thelma Hartwick Scholarship, $500. Abigail Reich, Dutcher Family Scholarship, $1,000. Alex and Esther Kennedy Memorial Scholarship, $500. Xavier Rulo, Catherine M. Boucher Scholarship, $500. Philip Noble Memorial Scholarship, $500. Jade Schultz, Julie Anderson Memorial Scholarship, $250. James and Lois Birch Health Occupations and Education Scholarship, $500. Kenneth and Cecilia Murray Family Scholarship, $1,000. Zonta Club of Alpena for Alpena High School Student Scholarship, $750. Aubrey Sheldon, Patricia A. France Memorial Scholarship, $750. Samantha L. Schrader Memorial Scholarship, $500. Michaela Smith, Robert L. Schulke Memorial Scholarship, $500. Rachel Sushek, Robert L. Schulke Memorial Scholarship, $500. Zonta Club of Alpena for Alpena High School Student Scholarship, $750. Ethan Thatcher, Joseph Pinson Scholarship, $500. Jenya Torsch, Sue E. Sandy Memorial Scholarship, $250. Congratulations to all of the Alpena High School graduating class of 2020. And for those scholarship students, we'll see you at Alpena Community College in the fall.
All right. Thank you very much. Congratulations to all of those students who are recognized with a tremendous amount of opportunity there from Alpena Community College. And as always, Alpena High School and Alpena Public Schools are very appreciative of our partnership with Alpena Community College. And we want to thank ACC for everything they do for both the students of Alpena High School and the community of Alpena at large. So again, thank you, Alpena Community College. Next, we have Mr. Lee Fitzpatrick, who is going to be doing the early college recognition.
Good evening, class of 2020. I'm here at one of my favorite places in the Alpena area, Rockport. Rockport represents nature to me, and nature is something that constantly changes and produces new challenges that you have to overcome. The goal in life is perseverance, and if you want to get to the top, you're going to have to face some challenges and push your way through them.
The plans that you decide on and work for will often change. You never know when the very ground beneath you will break loose, and you'll have to figure out another way.
You may recognize this is a point of great accomplishment, but also one that can be frightening with difficult challenges that come ahead. You'll have to learn to push through, have a plan, and to adjust where needed.
The community of Alpena looks forward to watching you achieve your goals and dreams and reach the heights. And we wish you all the best of luck. We'll be here to lift you up when you need it. And you are our future. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Absolutely. Well said, Mr. Fitzpatrick. Of course, none of us will be able to accomplish the great heights that Mr. Fitzpatrick attains to each and every day. But we hope that any height that you achieve is going to be somewhat measurable to what Mr. Fitzpatrick mentioned there in his video. So again, thank you very much, Mr. Fitzpatrick, for that. Next, we have Alpena High School Counselor, Mrs. Lori Vogt, is going to be discussing Michigan Competitive Scholarship. Of course, we have some technical difficulties here.
Hi, I'm Lori Vogt. I'm one of the counselors. I'm here today to announce a special group of seniors. These are our Michigan Competitive Scholarship qualifiers. These are students who scored very high on the spring 19 SAT exam. And they are Taylor Ayati, Kyle Barbeau, Cassidy Beach, Gabrielle Bourgeois, Nathan Bruder, Anna Berker, Hunter Canute, Benjamin Caribou, Ashwin Chapamohan, Aiden Chisholm, Jonathan Clayton, Kevin Cook, James Decker, Molly Dickinson, Matthew Fisher, Alyssa Funk, Morgan Glennie, Jack Hamp, Emmeline Hannah, Taylor Hanson Bates, Wenton Harrison, Amanda Johnson, Alec Kent, Cameron Krause, Mackenzie Linton, Abigail Lockhart, Danny Losinski, Olivia Losinski, Kimberly McConnell, Joshua Nowicki, Jenna Peterson, Joshua Pokrzynski, Nehemiah Rao, Wyatt Romero, Megan Rysnowski, Jake Schiller, Griffin Sexton, Georgia Smolinski, Matthew Spencer, Casey Stevens, Lindsay Sema, Samantha Tadian, Evan Thayer, Bradley Thompson, Madison Timmerick, Ethan Washburn, Aaron West, Eli Winter, Caleb Zaberni, Lauren Zan, Alex Zeliskowski, and Lauren Zeliskowski. Congratulations to our Michigan Competitive Scholarship Qualifiers. Make sure you fill out your FAFSA form at www.fafsa.gov to see if you qualify for a monetary award. Thanks, Greg. Congratulations to all the seniors.
All right, thank you, Mrs. Vogt. And again, congratulations to those students for the Michigan Competitive Scholarship performance. At this time, I want to recognize an opportunity that Alpena High School was provided by Lake Superior State University. As many of you know, Alpena is the district in Michigan that is the furthest away from any four-year institution. The closest actually is Saginaw Valley State, but Lake Superior State is the second closest by a matter of about 10 miles. This year, we were provided an opportunity to give 2 4-year full-ride scholarships, academic full-ride scholarships, to 2 Lake Superior State students that are Alpena High School students that are heading to Lake Superior State University. And at this time, I want to recognize Joshua Nowicki and Danielle Shackman, who were the 2 recipients of the Lake Superior State University Presidential Scholarship, which will give them upwards of 4 years free tuition at Lake Superior State. And it's especially exciting for me, being an alum of Lake Superior State. So it's pretty cool for this opportunity for 2 Alpena High School students. So go Wildcats and go Lakers. So that's pretty cool. Next up, we have Athletic Director Tim Storch, who is going to be presenting the Kim Park Award.
Greetings from a wonderful sunny afternoon on Grand Lake. Once again, it's my pleasure this year to award the Kim Park Award to a graduating senior athlete. Kim Park stood for wonderful academic achievements, as well as being a dedicated athlete and being involved in many extracurricular activities as well. This year, as in every year, we have wonderful female athletes to choose from, but the overwhelming consensus was to give the award to Molly Dickinson. Congratulations, Molly, on this well-deserved award.
Congratulations, Molly, Kim Park Award winner for 2019-2020. Congratulations to Molly. Next, we have Alpena High School Counselor Mary Dels presenting the Daughters of the American Revolution Good Citizen Award.
Good evening. The Daughters of the Revolution Good Citizen Program was created in 1934 and called the Dar Good Citizen Pilgrimage Committee. The committee's aim was to stress the qualities of good citizenship among senior high school students. In 1952, the name was changed to the Dar Good Citizens Committee and open to seniors of all accredited public and private high schools. Students selected as the school's Dar Good Citizen must have the qualities of leadership, dependability, service, and patriotism. Michigan's first place nomination and essay each year are sent to the National Vice Chairman of the East Central Division, which includes Indiana, Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and West Virginia for judging at the district level. The DAR has 8 districts, and the district winners are sent to the National Chairman in Washington, D.C. to be judged. The national winner is invited to the Continental Congress in Washington, D.C. for the summer convention to receive national awards. On behalf of the Chief Shawano Chapter, Daughters of the American Revolution, we congratulate you, Brooke Madison Mail, on being Alpena High School's DAR Good Citizen winner and Chief Shawano Chapter's DAR Good Citizen second place winner. There were over 600 schools who were contacted for this contest. You were selected as the recipient of this very prestigious award by your school teachers and counselors. God be with you in your future endeavors in life, and please continue the DAR motto, God, home, and country. Thank you.
All right, congratulations, Brooke Mail, for that recognition from the Daughters of the American Revolution. Next, we have the U.S. Marines, who have a short message that they would like to also share on the recognition.
Good evening, class of 2020. Congratulations on graduating. The Marine Corps has teamed up with your school to honor several students who we believe are truly deserving. It's unfortunate that we couldn't participate in an award ceremony in person, but these are unprecedented times, and we commend you on remaining resilient. First up, we have the Distinguished Athlete Award. To be successful in the Marine Corps, as in life, one must demonstrate strength of mind, body, and spirit. Tonight, it is my privilege to recognize students who have demonstrated those physical attributes that are the hallmark of Marines. Discipline, stamina, intestinal fortitude, and dedication. 4 attributes that have helped Marines perform incredible feats over the past 244 years. This year's recipients have continually shown the attributes in their pursuit of high school sports excellence. This year's recipients of the United States Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Awards are Jordan Schultz and Jade Schultz. Next up, we have the Scholastic Excellence Award. The Marine Corps core values of honor, courage, and commitment are best represented in high school by a student that has recognized the fact that to be successful in life, you must have the discipline and dedication to put forth your best effort to achieve any goal. This year's recipients are students that have demonstrated distinct leadership qualities while achieving outstanding academic achievement. This year's recipients of the United States Marine Corps Scholastic Excellence Awards are Kyle Barbeau and Hannah Schultz. Finally, we have the Semper Fidelis Award. The pursuit of excellence in one's chosen craft takes tremendous discipline and dedication. Tonight, it is my privilege to recognize student musicians who demonstrate the dedication, attention to detail, and technical skills that are the hallmark of the Marine Corps Music Program. These student musicians have conquered the challenges of high school music while embodying the Marine Corps core values of honor, courage, and commitment. This year's recipient of the United States Marine Corps Semper Fidelis Awards are Cameron Kraus and Samantha Atkinson. Congratulations, students. Thank you for your time.
Congratulations to all of those students being recognized by the United States Marine Corps. And that is also what makes Alpena High School tremendously special, is our relationship that we have with the armed service branches in our community. So again, thank you to the Marines. Next, we have Mark Holsey, who's going to be presenting the Optimist Scholarship Award.
Good afternoon. I'm Mark Holsey with the Alpena Optimist Club. It's a great pleasure that I have the opportunity to address the class of 2020. In a moment, I'll be presenting one of your classmates as a scholarship award winner for our club. Prior to announcing our award winner, I'd like to take a moment to speak to the class regarding the COVID-19 virus and the subsequent pandemic. In 1918 through 1920, my grandparents survived the Spanish flu pandemic that claimed 675,000 American lives, and that was during World War I. My grandparents and parents also survived the 1929 stock market crash and the subsequent Great Depression of the 1930s, when 30% of the workforce was unemployed. In the 1940s and 50s, my parents were participants in World War II in Korea, where over 1.1 million Americans killed or wounded. My generation dealt with 9/11. The point is that each generation, yours included, will deal with their own unique challenges and circumstances. What we must never lose sight of is that we are citizens of the greatest country of the world. Americans are resilient. We are fighters. We don't give up, and we don't throw the towel in because of some virus. We will not be defined by a virus, and you won't be either. Each of you has a destiny to fulfill, and part of that destiny is overcoming challenges and circumstances. This virus is a little more than a challenge to overcome, and I, along with your teachers and administrators who have guided you for the last 4 years, know that you're up to the challenge. I once had a football coach that challenged every student to be somebody. And that's the challenge that I lay out before you. Go out and be somebody. May God bless you in those endeavors. And as an optimist, I offer you our best wishes. At this time, it's my honor to announce the Optimist Club 2020 Class Scholarship Award winner as Gabrielle Borjage. Gabrielle is an outstanding student whose participation in a number of school activities and clubs was paramount in our selection as the scholarship award winner. On behalf of the Optimist Club, I offer our sincere congratulations to Gabrielle. Thank you, and God bless you each.
Thank you, Mark, and congratulations to Gabby on that tremendous honor. Next, we have Kara Barrow-Lemons, who's going to be presenting the Community Foundation of Northeast Michigan Youth Advisory Student of the Year.
Advisory Council is a youth philanthropy organization based on grant making, leadership, community service, and philanthropy.
There was a time when
the importance of youth philanthropy is just to instill a sense of giving and generosity into youth. Youth philanthropy translates into adult philanthropy. Youth Advisory Council promotes leadership by giving so many involved so much responsibility for what's going on in the community, as well as inspiring youth philanthropy amongst the peers. Taking initiative and the power that a youth voice can have. has given me so much confidence and taught me so many skills and life lessons that I will definitely take with me and use in adulthood.
All right. Congratulations, Jenna. Very well done. Jenna, Community Foundation, Northeast Michigan, for their Advisory Student of the Year. Congratulations to Jenna. Next, we have Christina Bright from New Life Lutheran to recognize their award.
Hello, Alpena graduates and your family and friends, teachers and staff there at Alpena, and any community members that may be watching this. My name is Reverend Christina Bright, and I am the pastor of New Life Lutheran Church on the south end of Hubbard Lake. Our congregation consists of people living throughout Alpena and Alcona counties, and as we discussed starting a scholarship fund and giving it away to local students in our area, we wanted to make sure that we included graduates from both Alcona and Alpena schools. I want to just take a few moments and say congratulations to all of our graduates. This year has not been anything like what we expected. Your graduation is not going to be anything like you wanted or expected, or this awards night, or the summer, or the beginnings of your school career beyond high school. But I have every confidence that you will face this and overcome it to the best of your ability, and hopefully all of us can do the same. On behalf of everyone at New Life Lutheran, our best wishes and our prayers to each and every one of you. As we looked at our scholarship applications, we were very impressed by all of your applications, by what you wrote about yourselves and your journeys so far and your educational journeys to come. Each and every one of you deserves this $500 scholarship, and if we had the capability, we would certainly give one to everyone that applied. In the end, ultimately, we thought Jonathan Vijakuski met the parameters of our scholarship the best. And so, Jonathan, congratulations to you. You certainly deserved it, as you wrote about your life and your plans for the future and what your needs may be. Congratulations again to all of you, and Jonathan, we will be contacting you shortly to get a few more details from you and to let you know the specifics of this scholarship. Thank you so much for this opportunity to speak to you, and have a safe and a good summer. And again, best wishes on your plans for the future. Take care.
Congratulations, Jonathan. And thank you for that, New Life Lutheran Church. We appreciate your willingness to be involved with Alpena Public Schools. Next, we have Alpena High School math teacher, Miss Melissa Jarima, with the Michigan Math Prize competition.
Hello, everyone. I'm Melissa Jarima with the AHS Math Department. Last fall, some students chose to participate in the Michigan Mathematics Prize competition. I would like to congratulate Emmeline Hannah for being first place with the highest score in Alpena County. Congratulations, Emmeline.
All right, congratulations, Emmeline, for first place Alpena County in the Michigan Math Prize competition. Next, we will have a presentation on Microsoft Office certification from Ms. Amanda Polarski's class. All right, congratulations to all those students who earn Microsoft Office Specialist Certification. Next, we will have Athletic Director Tim Storch is going to rejoin us. Of course, normally also in early May, we have our senior athletic banquet as well, but unfortunately, because of the closures and the pandemic issues, we're unable to have that as well. The big award that is handed out at the tail end of that banquet is the Male and Female Athlete of the Year Award. We did go through and did the voting on that, and Athletic Director Tim Storch is going to join us again on his beautiful boat, make us all jealous. And of course, he's going to be presenting the Male and Athlete Female of the Year.
Hello, Wildcats. This is the time of year we usually do our Athletic Senior Awards Banquet, but unfortunately, we're unable to be together, so I'm doing it virtually from my pontoon boat on Grand Lake. It's a beautiful day. This year, we had a number of well-deserving male and female athletes that could have been honored as Athlete of the Year. In fact, 15 of these athletes are going on to play college sports. But there were 4 males and 4 females that were nominated by their head coaches, and the 14 head coaches then got to vote and rank each of these nominees in the order of their preference. When that was done, a grand total of points was awarded each athlete. And the 4 athletes that were nominated for Male Athlete of the Year, alphabetically in order, were Gabe Bullis for his contributions in track, Jordan Schultz for his contributions in both football and basketball, Keegan Spulmer for his contributions in baseball, and Eli Winter for his contributions in football and in track. And of the 14 first place votes, Eli Winter garnered 11 of those votes and came away the winner. And we want to congratulate him on being named the Male Athlete of the Year. And at some future point in time, we'll be able to present the trophy to him with a media presentation as well. On the female side of things, again, 4 female athletes were nominated by their coaches. The 14 coaches then got to vote on them in order of preference, and a point total was given. And the 4 female athletes that were nominated, again, in alphabetical order, were Macy Dickinson, Jay Schultz, Anna Young, and Edie Zan. And each of them played a number of sports. As I said before, Macy Dickinson was a 3-sport athlete playing volleyball, basketball, and soccer. Jay Schultz was a softball player as well as a basketball player. Anna Young ran cross country, played basketball, and played soccer. And Edie Zan played volleyball, basketball, and soccer. And in a close vote, Anna Young garnered 8 of the first place votes and came away with a grand total that edged out the second place finisher. And therefore, Anna Young comes away as our Female Athlete of the Year. Congratulations to both Eli Winter and Anna Young. And we hope to have a future celebration with an awards and trophy presentation later this summer. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach Storch. And again, we want to make sure that we say our thanks to Mr. Storch, who is moving out of the athletic director's chair at the end of June. He will still remain coaching soccer for another decade or so, we hope. But again, thank you, Coach Storch, for everything you have done for Alpena Athletics. When I arrived here 3 years ago to now, Coach Storch has done an amazing thing with working on the floor in the gym, the new turf in the stadium, the lights, everything that Coach Storch has done in his time here at Alpena High School. So we are very, very grateful and thankful for Tim for everything he's done. So thank you, Tim. And we look forward to still seeing you on the sidelines at Wildcat Stadium, Park Family Field. Next, we have Stacy Martin, who is going to be presenting for the Excel Club.
Hi, my name is Stacy Martin, and I am here on behalf of the Exchange Club of Alpena to present the Stanley C. Beck Youth of the Year Scholarship. Gold and a member of the Alpena Exchange Club, and the Alpena High School Auditorium bears his name. Exchange Club is committed to promoting leadership and community service, among other things, and every year we award a $1,000 scholarship to an Alpena High School senior based on a whole lot of criteria, including a written essay. This year, the essay theme was, how do you intend to serve as an example now and in the future as a responsible American citizen? We had a whole lot of applicants this year, so thank you to everyone who participated. Alpena should be very proud of our young students. There's a lot of passion in our community, and it really shows. Amanda Johnson has been awarded our $1,000 scholarship. She's an amazing young lady, and I hope to meet her in person someday soon. Thank you on behalf of the Exchange Club of Alpena. Good luck, class of 2020, and go Kids!
Thank you, Stacy. We appreciate everything the Exchange Club does with Alpena High School, as well as the creation of the Excel Club a couple years ago. So thank you very much. Also, another ceremony we generally hold in early May is the Career Technical and Education Excellence Banquet. And again, unfortunately, became another postponement due to the global pandemic. So Mrs. McCoy asked me to do a video honoring the seniors who were awarded Career Technical Education Excellence honorees. And what you're about to see is what happens when a high school principal is bored in an empty high school.
Everybody, Tom Berman, senior principal of Alpena High School. I'm excited to announce this year's Career and Technical Education Awards. Each year, CTE teachers, students, parents, and industry partners celebrate CTE excellent students at the end of the school year. Each recognition is done at the end of the year banquet. However, this year, because of the current situation, we are unable to have our annual banquet. So instead, I'm going to make this pretty cool video and honor all of our career technical education students. Students are selected by their CTE teachers based on classroom leadership, attendance, performance, and accomplishments within their CTE class. The following seniors were selected for the 2019 and 2020 school year.
Marketing. Taylor Baker, Cody Pierce.
Health occupation.
Nikita Cordes, Emma Dockrell, Jade Schultz.
Digital media and business management.
Abigail Funk, Anita Rudy.
Business management.
Nikolai Diagrella.
Agricultural science.
Savannah Avent. Brooke Mail.
Auto technology.
Chase Alan.
Just remember, CTE and Alpena High School start here, go anywhere.
All right, again, that's what happens when you have a high school principal in an empty building. So again, congratulations to all those seniors who earned Career Technical Education Awards for their accomplishments in our CTE programs here at Alpena High School. Next, we're going to be joined again by Mrs. Mary Douse, who has a recognition from the AEA scholarship.
Good evening. My name is Mary Douse, president of the Alpena Education Association. The association is composed of nearly 200 members of the professional teaching staff of Alpena Public Schools. Each year, our scholarship committee solicits, reviews, and reviews the applications for these monetary awards. The members of the association annually dedicate a portion of their dues as a contribution to the scholarship fund. In addition to the financial contributions of our families, scholarships are also awarded to deserving students from memorial funds established by families to honor former teachers and students of Alpena Public Schools. Our first award tonight is the Ruth Bronson Memorial Scholarship, which is named and established by the Bronson family in the memory of Ruth. Ruth Bronson was an outstanding elementary school teacher in Alpena who passed away early in her career. Two scholarships are being awarded this year, Each is a $500 one-year scholarship. This year's recipients are Lindsay Simi and Austin Ritter. This year, the Alpena Education Association Scholarship is being awarded to a student as a part of our members' commitment to the education of the youth of this district. The scholarship is an unrestricted award of $500 for each of 2 years. On behalf of the teachers of the Alpena Public Schools, it is my pleasure to present the Alpena Education Association Scholarship to this year's recipient, Mackenzie Linton. And our last scholarship this evening is the Knowledge Has Value Scholarship. Members of the AEA established this scholarship beginning in 2011. The scholarship, named the Knowledge Has Value Scholarship, has the intent to help students pursue education in any field. This award for $1,000 is being awarded to Lindsay Simi. Congratulations to our winners. I would also like to take a moment to congratulate all of the 2020 graduates of Alpena High School. Your hard work and perseverance through this very unusual school year is a testament to all you have done and accomplished. We are proud of you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mrs. Dowse. Again, congratulations to the recipients of the AEA scholarships. Next, we have Alpena High School Counselor, Mrs. Robin Miller, who is going to present AP awards.
Hello, students and families and staff. My name is Mrs. Robin Miller, and I am a high school counselor here at Alpena High School. I have the honor of announcing our students who have been awarded the AP Scholar Award and the AP Scholar with Distinction Award. AP is Advanced Placement. An Advanced Placement is a program created by the College Board which offers college-level curriculum and exams to high school students. American colleges and universities may grant placement then and course credit to students who obtain high exam scores. The AP Scholar Award is granted to students who achieve scores of 3 or higher on 3 or more AP exams. And we have 10 of our seniors here at Alpena High School who have achieved this great award. Those students are Cassidy Beach, Ashley Bridgewater, Ashwin Chopamahang, Fletcher Chimner, Alyssa Funk, Friday King, Jenna Peterson, Casey Stevens, Aaron West, and Isaac Wolford. Congratulations, students. We have the AP Scholar with Distinction Award. And this award is given to those students whose average is a minimum of 3.5 on all of their AP exams and a score of 3 or more on at least 5 of their exams. We have 3 seniors who have achieved this award. Those students are Emmeline Hannah, Taylor Hansen Bates, and Nehemiah Rao. Congratulations, students. Have a wonderful rest of your evening. Thank you.
All right, congratulations to those students who have earned recognition through Alpena High School's Advanced Placement Programs. The final scholarship presentation we have for this evening is we have John Johnston, who is joining us with the Johnston Scholarship.
Good evening. I hope this video finds everyone safe and healthy. I'm Jeff Johnston, and I'm here this evening to present for the 29th time the Frederick T. and Betty D. Johnston Scholarship Awards. These awards are given every year to honor and memorialize my parents, Fred and Betty Johnston, as outstanding parents who believed in supporting our youth and our community. The scholarship awards are chosen by Scholarship Committee of the Alpena Public Schools based on a written essay by the student and on their academic achievements and extracurricular activities. This year, the winner of a $1,000 scholarship is Taylor Hansen Bates. Congratulations, Taylor. Our second winner of a $500 scholarship goes to Elizabeth Kalashevsky. Congratulations, Elizabeth. And our third and final $500 scholarship winner is Mackenzie Linton. Congratulations to all of our scholarship winners this evening. Thank you, and remember to stay safe, stay healthy. Congratulations to all.
All right, thank you, Jeff. We appreciate that very much. And we appreciate everything you continue to do for Alpena Public Schools in the name of your parents. So at this time, I am going to turn the virtual stage over to Alpena High School English teacher, Ms. Paula Gerke, who is going to go through the list of some more individualized scholarships.
Andy Arianbold, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from Mongolia. Ivo Arvidsson Alberg, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from Sweden. Samantha Atkinson, U.S. Marine Corps Semper Fidelis Award for Musical Excellence. Maya Ayala, U.S. Figure Skating Graduating Seniors Program Bronze Award. Taylor Baker, ACC Doreen McClay Memorial Scholarship. Kyle Barbeau, U.S. Marine Corps Scholastic Excellence Award. Yurnar Batskanov, ASSE Community Service Award, ASSE Distinguished Achievement and International Understanding Certificate, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from Kazakhstan. Cassidy Beach, University of Michigan Kessler Scholarship. Ashley Bridgewater, Michigan Army National Guard Recruit. Alexandria Bruning, Art Club Founders Recognition Award. Gabrielle Bolas, U.S. Naval Academy Recruit. Napat Burana Kiriyako, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from Thailand. Ashwin Chapamohan, Central Michigan University Maroon and Gold Scholarship. Central Michigan University Multicultural Advancement Scholarship. Nicholas Chobanu, ASSE Community Service Award, Baker College Board of Regents Scholarship, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from Romania. Brett Shupka, Lake Superior State University Academic Honors Silver Scholarship, Lake Superior State University Anchor Award. Jonathan Clayton, Davenport University Cabinet Scholarship, Davenport University Presidential Scholarship, Davenport University Panther Pride Scholarship, Presqu'ile Electric and Gas Communities First Fund Scholarship. Molly Dickinson, Northeast Michigan Community Foundation Kimberly Park Female Athlete Award, Northwood University 2019 Junior Business Student of the Year Scholarship, Northwood University Presidential Scholarship, Northwood University Distributive Education Clubs of America Scholarship, Northwood University Niagelli Competitive Scholarship. Pioneer State Mutual Alpena and Lapin Agencies Merit Scholarship. Amelia Dixon, Grand Valley State University Early Awareness Scholarship. Grand Valley State University Laker Scholarship. Time Diltata, Cultural Enrichment Award Exchange Student from Thailand. Matthew Fisher, Detroit News Catch Award nominee for mathematics, Michigan Technological University Presidential Achievement Scholarship, National Merit Scholarship finalist. Alyssa Funk, Zonta Club of Alpena AHS senior woman attending a four-year university or college scholarship. Sangoon Gambold, Cultural Enrichment Award exchange student from Mongolia. Savannah Hall, Art Club Recognition Award. Jack Hamp, Central Michigan University Maroon and Gold Scholarship. Emmeline Hanna, Bob Tennis Scholarship.
University of Michigan Regents Merit Scholarship, University of Michigan Jones Trust ILAC Scholarship, Detroit News Catch Award nominee for journalism, National Merit Scholarship finalist. Taylor Hanson Bates, University of Michigan Scholarship Grant, University of Michigan Go Blue Scholarship Grant, University of Michigan Summers Family Scholarship, LSA, Northeast Michigan Community Foundation Frederick T. and Betty B. Johnston Scholarship, 2019 grad. Rachel Hart, Oakland University Geographic Region Award, Oakland University Recognition Award. Tanya Hemmingson, MMPA Ag-Related Scholarship. Zeynep Joswiak, University of Illinois at Chicago Merit Scholarship. Elizabeth Kalishewski, Northeast Michigan Community Foundation Frederick T. and Betty D. Johnston Scholarship. Cameron Krause, U.S. Marine Corps Semper Fidelis Award for Musical Excellence. Toby Kruger, U.S. Army Recruit. Alexandra Reno, Alpena Exchange Club Accepting the Challenge of Excellence Award. Mackenzie Linton, Grand Valley State University Laker Award for Excellence Scholarship. Northeast Michigan Community Foundation Frederick T. and Betty D. Johnston Scholarship. Brooke Mayo, Ed Buck Career and Technical Education Scholarship. Joshua Nowicki, Lake Superior State University Presidential Scholarship. Eva Peng, Cultural Enrichment Award Exchange Student from China. Jack Peplinski, U.S. Navy Military Recruit. Jenna Peterson, Youth Advisory Council for Northeast Michigan Youth Trustee. Mitchell Pfeiffer, Olivet College Dean Scholarship. Sam Romero, Olivet College BMOR Scholarship, Olivet College Board of Trustees Scholarship, Olivet College Merit Scholarship, Knights of Columbus Scholarship for Service to School and Parish Community, State of Michigan Veterans Tuition Grant. Haley Rondo, Cornerstone University Presidential Scholarship, Cornerstone University Music Scholarship, Cornerstone University Track and Field Scholarship. Xavier Rulo, Art Club Founders Recognition Award. Ona Barrey Ramis, Cultural Enrichment Award, Exchange Student from Spain. ASSE, Distinguished Achievement and International Understanding Certificate. Megan Rosnowski, Grand Valley State University Laker Scholarship. Danielle Shackman, Lake Superior State University Presidential Scholarship. Hannah Schultz, U.S. Marine Corps Scholastic Excellence Award. Jade Schultz, U.S. Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award. Zonta Club AHS Senior Attending ACC Scholarship. Jordan Schultz, U.S. Marine Corps Distinguished Athlete Award. Griffin Sexton, Horatio Alger Association Scholarship. Hagen Foundation Scholarship. Dominic Smith, U.S. Marine Corps Recruit. Casey Stevens, Greenstone Farm Credit Services Scholarship. Michigan State University Honors Commended Scholarship. Rachel Shushek, Zonta Club AHS Senior Attending ACC Scholarship. Knights of Columbus Scholarship, Excellence in Character. Lindsay Simi, Detroit News Catch Award nominee for Health. Saginaw Valley State University Founders Scholarship. Samantha Tadian, Michigan State University Honors Commended Scholarship. Madison Timrick, Zonta International Young Women in Public Affairs Scholarship. Jenya Torsch, Michigan Technological University Society of Women Engineers Certificate of Merit. Victoria Baye Morano, ASSE, Distinguished Achievement and International Understanding Certificate, Cultural Enrichment Award, Exchange Student from Spain. Aaron West, Kettering University First Robotics Scholarship. Kettering University Trustee Scholarship. Kettering University Grant. Jonathan Bijakuski, New Life Lutheran Church Scholarship, Jinglong Yang, Cultural Enrichment Award, exchange student from China, ASSE, Distinguished Achievement International Understanding Certificate, Eden Zan, Delta College, Hilda and Walter Heyman Scholarship.
All right, congratulations to all Alpena High School students who have earned these recognition, these special recognitions. Area. We also have a few awards that came in after Mrs. Gerke recorded these names. So I want to make sure I congratulate Jonathan Clayton, who is recognized with the Alpena Evening Lions Club Scholarship. Kevin Cook, University of Michigan W. Garrison Memorial Scholarship. GVSU Award for Excellence Scholarship, GVSU Early Awareness Scholarship, GVSU Presidential Scholarship, Nikita Cortez, PIENG Scholarship, Matthew Milliston, Ferris State University Gold Scholarship. That concludes all of the scholarships that we have to recognize this evening. If for some unknown reason a scholarship was missed, or you do receive a scholarship after this evening's festivities, please make sure that you get it to your counselor so that we can make sure we get you recognized. I know this year we were excited to have National Merit finalists for the second straight year with Emmeline Hanna and Matthew Fisher. So congratulations to them. I know we'll be hearing soon from National Merit on what scholarships they will be awarded for that. So we're looking forward to hearing from them. If you were recognized in a video tonight and you would like a copy of that video, please reach out to me via email, and I'll be more than happy to share the video with you of you being recognized tonight with your honor. I also want to give another special recognition to Lindsay Simi, who was recognized today in the Detroit News Outstanding Senior Edition for her performance in the healthcare industry. So congratulations to Lindsay. That was today, so we'll make sure we get that out there. So we want to congratulate the class of 2020 for everything they have accomplished. I know there are great things yet to come. And I know this year that the end of their high school chapter was not the ending that they wanted to be written. And unfortunately, it was written for them and was out of their control. But the good news is that the next chapter of their life begins very shortly. And that next chapter, they will have complete control over how it is written. And we're excited to see what each and every one of you comes up with. And again, the formatting of our celebrations here at the end of the year is not what the focus should be. The focus should be on all of the accomplishments of each and every one of these young men and women. Again, we want to express our biggest congratulations to the class of 2020. Congratulations to the parents and families of the graduates for sharing in this accomplishment, for everything that they have done in their high school career here at Alpena High School. And as we say, once a Wildcat, always a Wildcat. Again, thank you and have a good evening.